Am I good? We're ready to roll?
You are prepped.
That's how I roll. You ready?
I'm ready.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Living 4D with Paul CHEK. It's exciting today. Well, let's get into some of this discussion on your new program, because I really think it's an important program for people. And I'll give you guys all a hint that are listening. I'm promoting Mike's Kettlebell Lifestyle Program, which I don't normally do because I don't want to draw people away from the CHEK Institute's teachings. But the unique thing is that I felt so compelled to do this because, one, with the whole COVID environment, we really need something that guides people step by step and gives them the support they need, so that if they're a beginner, then they have the support of a coach. But if they're more advanced, they have the support of a world champion athlete in this sport with a lot of experience and multiple Russian master's titles under his belt. So if you're going to learn how to do something, learn how to do it from the best. That's what I always tell people. Knowing you and seeing your previous program and knowing how well you do stuff, I thought I got to help Mike promote this, because there's just so many people out there in the world that just need to get moving. And with all the gyms being shut down, they just shut the gyms down in San Diego again. Don't get me started on what I think about all that, but you know, the reality of it is there's just a huge percentage of the population. Research I ran across a number of years ago by Michael Mogadun, who's got a master's degree in public health, showed that only 8% of women, and I think it was 3% of women, do any regularly scheduled exercise on any given day, and that included walking a dog. So when you consider that about 97% of women and 94% of men are sedentary, but clearly one of the beautiful things about COVID is it's shown that the people that are really having the problems are the people that are already not taking care of themselves. So all my friends in the health and exercise business that have, you know, health products or good exercise systems or online training have all seen huge increases in business, which means people are waking up to the fact that it's time to start getting involved in them, in their life, and taking care of themselves. I thought we could dive in with a discussion of how this program is really important for mind-body fitness, not just physical fitness, but mind-body fitness and even emotional fitness, because you really have to learn to manage your emotions if you want to push yourself to levels of conditioning that are of any significance. I mean, yeah, you can be sedentary and get generally fit without too much emotionally stressing. In other words, you know, the discipline it takes and listening to your kind of self that wants to cop out and saying, oh, you don't need to do that today, you're tired, or you did this, you got to go do this, you got to do, you know, all the excuses the head generates. So I really want to talk about this from the bigger perspective of how it's relevant to what's going on in the world right now and what's always going on in the world.
I love that. You know, I think one of the biggest things, like my dream when I created this program, and it still is very true right now and moving forward, is to create and support 10,000 balanced athletes in the world.
That's a nice goal.
Let's
go to 100.
I like it. Let's up it.
Go to them all.
Well, it's that, you know, the description that many of the people have gone through the program so far. So we have people representing over 20 countries in the program from all walks of life, from I've got firefighters to construction workers to musicians to cooks to former athletes to current athletes. And I would say, you know, I give surveys throughout the program, especially with the beta groups that I took through it, to get feedback and to make it better. And there was three words that kept coming up, and it was comprehensive, integrated, and the one that came up the most was intentional.
Good.
And so the program is not only an accurate reflection of how I train and how I coach and teach, but the program's truly is all, the name of the program is Kettlebell Lifestyle, because the lifestyle aspect of it is equally, if not more important than everything you do with a bell. You know, my goal was, just like you taught me and trained me and how I coach, it's when people go through the program, we're utilizing a kettlebell, one bell, so it's very accessible to anybody. Kettlebell is a fantastic total body training tool. But really, it's about developing a healthy training lifestyle, healthy movement lifestyle that incorporates elements, you know, that we can talk about, the four doctors and how those things, and it's for me, it's about connecting people with the self-awareness and the internal knowledge that they have themselves. And to manage their body mind, they need to check in with themselves.
Yes.
And that's a huge, if that, that I would say is probably the most important personalized aspect of the program that truly makes it holistic, that when you go through it, you can apply those principles to any program in the future that you do.
Yes.
Checking in with your stress level, checking in with your muscle and joint soreness level, checking in with how's your gut doing, your motivation level. All those things are hugely, hugely important. That I am a fan when there's a time and a place for technology, but when you master these questions that you can just answer in 15 to 30 seconds, you could be in the woods training, you could be wherever.
You are the technology.
You are the technology.
This is where I don't like biohacking, because as you and I have discussed before, you become reliant on gadgets. But what this is what I call bioharmonizing. You're integrating your perceptual faculties, your ability to be aware of what's happening in yourself with your body. So instead of needing a gadget to interface with what you should be aware of, you're actually interfacing with the rest of yourself. So the deeper you go in that way, the more intimate and the more aware you get of what's happening inside yourself. And because a lot of most athletes lack that, that's why there's a lot of injuries that wouldn't happen if they were more tuned in, because they would realize, okay, something's happening with my Achilles tendon or my shoulder way in advance. But, you know, the old follow the program no matter what, no pain, no gain, get out there and do it, just ruins more athletes, unfortunately, than it actually creates, which is never ideal.
That's what happened to me time and time again. And that was such, like, I do my best to bring as much heart to the program. And anyone who goes through it and sees it, hopefully, even before you get in the program, there's an onboarding questionnaire and a process that you go through that you'll know right away how different the program is. And the questionnaire, before you even lift a bell, not only serves to give you the recommended level that you should be to start with, but more than anything, you will learn so much about yourself just by considering, what is really the quality of my sleep? What is my hydration level? What does my posture look like? A lot of times, even when I'm teaching and I ask, you know, people like, what's kind of your experience level with bells? And, oh, they go, Mike, I'm good. You know, I can do X, Y, and Z. I'm like, okay. And I would say about 98% of the time, I'm like, whoa, this person needs to go way back in the needs to regress way back. And I feel like many coaches, trainers, and we have an unrealistic view of where we are.
Actually, research shows that the average person overestimates their own level of competency or skill by 70%.
Wow.
So if you say to someone, rate how good of a driver you are on a scale of 1 to 10, and then they take them to a driving course and test them, which is one of the ways they did this, the average person overestimates their actual abilities by about 70%.
Wow.
Except me. If I challenge you, you know it's going to be real.
Oh,
I had
one
of my buddies in here the other day who esteems himself as a stud. So after hearing all this monkey business for a while, I said, okay, it's time for the old man to put an end to that. So, you know, he's much younger than me. He's in his 30s, so I jumped up and banged out 4 single-arm chin-ups and said, okay. And he had his girlfriend with him. I said, your turn. And he couldn't even get one. So I said, now quit yakking about how damn fit and strong you are, would you? I'm old enough to be your father. You might want to read how to eat, move, and be healthy to start with.
Yeah.
But anyhow, let's get into some of these important points I want to discuss with you. But I'm going to read you the question here, just because there's some kind of framework. I want to set the question up so that when we get into it, we know exactly what we're talking about. It's apparent to me that the whole COVID crisis has really brought to light the importance of the power of mind. What we believe is what we create within and around us, both personally and collectively. Those most challenged by issues of COVID are those most challenged with self-management as a general theme. Overweight, out of shape, not eating or living well, and not using their mind to discern fact from make-believe in the media. Whenever we believe in a new dragon, i.e. the issues at hand, we invite a new dragon into our lives. regardless of one's disposition as to the true nature of COVID, what remains real and always real in any time and in any personal, social, or collective circumstance is how one manages themselves with in regard to their four doctors, which is, you know, mind, movement, diet, and rest. So, Mike, let's look at your kettlebell lifestyle program from the perspective of what it offers anyone with regard to creating open-mindedness, mental awareness, and resilience in each of the four doctors so people can gain awareness of how powerful the kettlebell lifestyle program is for each key four-doctor aspect of their lives. So if we start with Dr. Happiness, which in my model, Dr. Happiness is the domain of mind, correlates to the air element, which is also linked to mind and breathing, of course. And mind and the air element represent spring in the four seasons. Spring is the beginning of a new program, for example. The decision to start anything new would be springtime. So even if it's winter time outside, but you start a new project like building a new program or building a new house, it's springtime. Springtime is when we plan and get ourselves ready, like a New Year's resolution or your goals for the year would be spring. So from a perspective of creating happiness, I tell people, you know, as you know all the time, if you don't identify what's happy making for you, include those activities somehow, some way on a daily basis, then the next thing you know is you're expecting someone else to make you happy, or you need some drug or, you know, some addictive food to create happiness for you, which creates a bit of a trap. But really, when it comes to taking care of our bodies and doing a conditioning like your mastering kettlebell program or kettlebell lifestyle program, either of them, and mastering the kettlebell is still available, right?
Yep. That's basically become what I've realized is the level of depth in there. It's truly like a trainer's education program, over 400 videos. This is the complementary aspect to that, which is the guided follow along workout program.
Yeah. So this is really designed for anybody at home, either from beginners to more fit athletes that just want to get skilled training.
100%.
So really, let's talk about that. You know, how do you see this program, kettlebell lifestyle, correlating to creating happiness, using your mind effectively, getting a new start, and breathing?
Yeah. So what I'm observing in people today is, like you mentioned, they're stuck up in their mind, right? But what's in their mind is basically
dragons,
fear, survival. And one of the most powerful things in my experience that anybody can do to get out of their mind and into their body, into their heart, into their root, and getting stable is through the breath.
Yes.
And so what I created in the program was essentially under 10-minute long morning routines. You can do them in the morning or really any time of day. Mm-hmm. And the whole focus is gentle movement, warming
yes.
up the spine,
mm-hmm.
and then simple breathing exercises that basically teach you how to truly breathe in 3D.
Good.
So each phase builds on the one prior, and there's a new morning routine. So there's follow along, as I mentioned, and what I found just simply, you know, every single aspect of the program, and I've heard this from many students, whether it's the personalized stretching program or the morning routines, yes, as a whole, it can be really, really powerful. But what I said is what I've shared with people is the goal is to get people first and foremost in touch with their body so they develop that self-awareness from a grounded place to really understand who's running the show.
Yeah.
You know, is it the media running the show? Is it them? What ideas are theirs? What ideas are external?
Yeah.
And you can't do that unless you're grounded in your body.
You can't.
Thank you.